E-learning module presented by ETDC Vijayawada ST Railway. The topic is tripping fails. How to attend troubleshooting for load junction A beginning, A ending, operation B part 1, part 2, operation O 1, part 2, and danger tripping without apparent cause. Load junction. Abnormal sign. Close BLDC, plus BLRDC, LSC is extinguished, U meter will not emit, natural sound will not heard, LSC will also not extinguished. After 5.6 seconds, LSC reclosed. This is the abnormal sign for load junction. Collisions. Accident or derailment of the formation or infringement with the voltage. There is no voltage supply. Pantone not rising properly or not touching to the contact wire. Cut in loop bars towards the riser to pantone. Foreign body on the local roof causing acting of OHE. So there is a cut in main winding or axle winding of the transformer, local transformer. Whenever there is no OHE, while working a train, if there is no OHE, 230 will energize. In 230, normal open rock will come to the normal position on 244 branch and DJ will after preparation and picking abnormal sign. If we close this, close the DC, DC will close, LSC will extinguish, U meter will not emit, actual sound will not come, LSC will not extinguish because there is no OHE supply. The supply is not coming to axillary, there is no OHE, U meter will not come, actual sound will not come, and LHP also will not extinguish. QCR also will not pick up. So starting phase will not cut off. The 7-8 interlock, normally closed interlock which was open in open position. And these motors will not start. MASL1, MASL2, direct motors, MPH, these were also not. So after 5 seconds, Q8 will de-energize. And this interlock will open on 244 branch. Now after 0.6 seconds, Q44 will energize. And Q44 interlock open and now Q44 branch. MPTC, Q44 interlock will open and MPTC branch. And MPTC will de-energize. Leisure trips. This is the abnormal sign for load junction. So how to attend? If any formation derail or accident takes place, any infringement of OHE, track defect or something, observing of VP drop is or abnormality in the formation, immediately put on flashlight, secure the train, protect the train, speedometer, memory free switch to be on, broken the glass and switch on, check adjacent line and act according to the GNSS. Second one, no OH is applied. For ensuring of no OH is applied, while rising the pantou, we can observe sparks near contact wire. If sparks are coming, OH supply is there. If sparks are not coming, there is no OH supply. We have to inform the TPC. We have to ensure that on pantou properly rise in touching to OH. If pantou not rise, we can again troubleshooting for electrical problems, pneumatic and mechanical of pantou not rising. If properly not rising, try with other pantographs. If any sparks or flashes observed on the local roof and pantos rising from both the caps, lower the pantou and inform the TPC. If any one of the pantou is rising and able to close DC, work with the single pantou. Fourth one. If any cut in roof bars notice roof bar cut for the pantou rising or foreign body on or if any abnormality on the local roof, so cut in roof bars or foreign body or any abnormality in the local roof, stop the drain, secure, inform TPC or TLC. They will arrange TRD staff for attention. The TRD staff will come, they will take the port mark, they will come with along with ladder. So LP has to ground the loco, climb on the loco roof along with TRD staff, attend the trouble, isolate considered equipment, precautions we can work. If there is no abnormality of above problems, nothing abnormality is noticed, so inform to the TLC. So it may be cut in main winding or auxiliary winding. Act as per the instructions of TLC. So we'll see once again troubleshooting. So first case, action derailment, BP dropping or any abnormal in the formation or track, switch on first aid, act according to the JDS. If OH supply is not there, contact. If pantou not rising properly, touching the top contact point. So attempt the troubleshooting for pantou not rising. Not success. Try with other pantou. So while rising of pantou, any flashes observed on the roof, lower the both pantous, inform the TPC. If any other pantou, the problem success means with a target single pantou. Any foreign body, cut in roof bars, any abnormality notice on the roof, inform TPC. TRD staff will come, along with TRD staff, attend the problem. If power is restored after 5 minutes of experiencing of no tension trouble and no information regarding OH supply, so automatically power was restored after 5 minutes. So not having any information regarding OH failure, then clear the section with SP detection of 60 power 30. If U is clear 60, if U is not clear 30 kPa. be observing the adjacent lion. If an abnormality notice in Movichi, protected in Bombay, you see what ALC. There is no abnormality also. Clear section and inform the station master. So, next trouble. Operation A beginning. Troubleshooting for operation A beginning. Abnormal sign. Rose BLDC, is Press BLRDC, LSCC will click on. Means DC will close and extinguish. DC will click on. While closing BLDC, pressing BLRDC, LSCC will extinguish and immediately close, and DC will close and trip immediately. So it will flicker. That problem will call as operation A begin. Reasons: QLA malfunctioning, QLA acting while closing up DC, temporary earth fault in auxiliary power circuit. So while closing up DC, temporarily QA is acting. After that, it was DNS. Temporary earth fault of traction circuit. QP1, QP2. QPD is a malfunctioning. Whenever the pressure is reducing after blowing up AC, QPD is a malfunctioning. While closing DC, QPD is a analyzing, after going up DC, if it is analyzed, this is not open, disabled. So, all machine of QPDC. In 6 branches, low. If MTDC is defective, if DC will close and MTDC is not analyzing, it will not hold. DC will not move and DC will hit. This MDC coil defective in 6 notches before only. So temporary earth fault through QOE, QOP1, QOP2, QLA malfunctioning, QPDC malfunctioning. If DC is analyzing but MTC is not analyzing, 6 branches. In 5 branches, if MTDC is defective, you will experience ICDC. In 6 branches, if MTDC is defective, you will experience ABA. So, troubleshooting. Operation A beginning experience. Tap the relays. If any relay target drop, attend for that one. There is no dropping of any relay target. Try by HQA 0, HQP 1 off, HQP 2 off, and try. Over off and try also. Build up maximum pressure and try. Not success. Tap QPDC if available near HT compartment. If still not success, we have to contact PLC. So, troubleshooting will say. So, tap the safe release and try. Try to build up the pressure, maximum pressure. Tap QPDC and try. HQA 0 and try HOP 1 off and HOP 2 off and V1 OBA off and try. Still not success, we have to contact the AMC. This is operation A beginning. Next, operation A ending. Abnormal sign. Close BLDC, press BLRDC, LSD extinguish, humidity deviates, at least sound may or may not have. LSHP will not extinguish after 5.6 seconds. LSHP reglow. It is for operation A ending. Defective or no, or defective case where? If or no defective, not get any axillary sound. If QCR defective, will get axillary sound, but LSHP will not extinguish. So, how to attend trouble? We'll see. If R not effective, these axillary motors will not start, that motors will not start. And QCR also will not pick up. So while picking up abnormal sign, LSA extinguish, humidity deviates, LSA sound will not add, LSA will also be not extinguished for 5.6 seconds, humanoid initially disabled. If QCR is defective, while picking abnormal sign, the QCR normally open lock will not close, starting phase will not also cut off. After 5.6 seconds, disabled. So, how to attend troubleshooting? If R not effective, that means there is no sound or any abnormalities, no smell fire from R no. There is no axillary sound. So, we have to ask for relief. Axillary sound experiencing. We are experiencing operation A and D. That is defective QCR. QCR will have three interlocks. One is on QNET branch. Normally, we interlock on QNET branch. One more interlock on CUNET branch. One more interlock on LSHP, signal arm. So, QCR will have three interlocks. One is on current branch, one is on CUNET branch, and one more on LSHP. For troubleshooting, we will keep HQCR on 0. Whenever we will keep HQCR on 0,
choose your normally open and lock non-turret branch will bypass. QCR will not bypass. If you keep HQCR on 0, this normally open QCR and lock will be bypassed on turret branch. If you keep HQCR on 0, while closing up DZ, LSHP will not establish. Because QCR is defective, double equivalent lock on LSHP lamp, QCR double equivalent lock will close, and LSHP remains free. So while closing DZ, we have to release BLDZ after 4 seconds. After extinguishing of LSHP, we have to count for 1, 2, 3, 4 like this, and we have to release BLDZ. If you are not released BLDZ within 4 seconds, after 4 seconds, that is BLDZ not released means Q45 analysis condition, where QCR is defective, starting phase will not cut off, and the starting phase interlock will be in open position, non-current branch, after 5.6 seconds, DZ will turn. If you experience any problem, by closing up DZ after keeping HQCR 0. So, we have to release BLDZ after 4 seconds of LSHP extinguish. If you are not ready within 4 seconds, DZ will trip through June 8 after 5.6 seconds. Sharply, we have to count and release BLDZ. Third, any problem is there, we should not wait Q45. If you wait Q45, so any problem with QCR, if you wait Q45, CRN starting phase will pick up, the product will close permanently. Starting phase will not cut off. This interlock will open and DZ will not hold, and we should not give starting phase continuously to the onboards. So, once again, we see operation ending. Now, same reasons is armor and QCR effective. Armor effective will ask for everything. If QCR effective will keep HQCR on 0, keep HQCR on 0. The interlock of normal interlock on turret branch will bypass. We cannot bypass internally. So, precautions. LSHP will glow continuously. So we have to check LSHP working frequently. We have to release the BLDZ promptly after 4 seconds of LSHP extinguish. At any cost, we should not wait to 45 if any problem is there. Ending completed. Next, we will see operation B part 1. Operation B part 1. Abnormal sign and troubleshoot. Close BLDZ, press BLDZ, LSHP extinguish, humidity waits, address sound had, LSHP also extinguish, release BLDZ, while counting 15 seconds, LSHP reboots. It's called Operation B part 1. So reasons: effective MASL1, QSL1, MASL2, QSL2, MPH, QPH, QCR normally open interlock on unit branch defective. So while closing DC, when HP on, for Q18 the path will come like this. C105, 106, 107, 244, 246 marks through Q18. While closing it is a Q44 will energize. Interlock will open. After closing up DC, Q9 will get path like this. So after closing up DC, the path will come like this to the Q9. So here change is from path 1 to path 2 is now instead of Q44 interlock, now QSL1, QSL3, QH, QCR interlocks will scale. So if any problem in MASL1, QSL1, MASL2, QSL2, MPH or QPH or QCR interlock, we'll explain operation B part 1. After raising up wheel and Z while counting 15 seconds, DC will click. LSE will break you. So, defective MASL1, QSL1, MASL2, QSL2, MPH, QPH, or QSR. To find out the trouble, that the motors are working or not, we have to close DC. So, for closing up DC, we have to maintain a path through the Q9H. So by keeping switches HVSL1, HVSL2 on 3, HVH on 0, HQSR on 0, we can maintain a path to Q9H. We will bypass all 4 relays QSL1, QSL2, QPH, QSR interlock. So we will maintain a path to the Q9 branch. So we have to close it easier by keeping switches HVSL1, HVSL2 on 3, HVH on 0, HQSR on 0. And after bypassing, close it easy. Check working of motors. If MASL1, MASL2 is working, we can clear the section with observing current readings because MPH will not work. MPH cannot observe whether working or not. We have to follow current readings. If MASL1 is not working or MASL2 is not working, isolate Concentrac with 50% off load. If MASL1 is not working, isolate track 1, work with 50% off maximum load. If MASL2 is not working, isolate track 2 and work with 50% off maximum load. If both motors are working, by observing current readings 920/500, duly observing transformer oil level, we can clear section. After clearing of section, so if motors are working, MASL1, MASL2 are working properly, after clearing of section, switch HVSL1 we have to knock. One question we have to keep.
If DJ drives, we can conclude QSL1 is effective. Because here HVSL1 only 0 and 3 only the path will be maintained. When I normalize the HVSL1 to 1 position, if now DJ drives, that effective is QSL1. So if QSL1 is defective, keep HVSL1 on 3, close the DC, work further duly observing MVSL1 working. If DC not trip, keep HVSL2 normal and try. If DC trip, defective QSL2. So keep HVSL2 on 3 position. Close the DC, duly observing MVSL2 working, work further. So after keeping off HVSL1, HVSL2 on normal position, one position, vision not rip. Next, keep switch HVH to be in normal position. Keep HVH on one position. If DJ drips, defective may be MPH or QPH. Because we cannot ensure working of MPH, the defective may be MPH or QPH. So we have to inform TLC. So we can work with current readings 920 bar 500. 920 for starting, 500 for continuous. Starting 5 minutes 920 and continuous 500 amps. As per the instructions of TLC. After HPH normal also, DJ not trip, defective. Is your interlock. So already we have isolated HQCR on 0. So work normal, duly ensure working of magnetics and RNO. We can work normal. So operation B part 1, sign, reasons. So we have to keep troubleshooting for operation B part 1. We have to keep switches HVSL1, HVSL2 on 3 position, HVH on 0, HQSR on 0. HPH will keep on 0 because we are not initial working of MPH. So operation B part 1. So we have to ensure working of MSL1 and MSL2. This is an abnormality. Keep switches HVSL1, HVSL2 on 3, HPH, HQSR on 0. Close the DC and ensure working of MSL1, MSL2. They are working. Okay, if they are not working, isolate the concentric truck. Work with 50% of maximum. If MSL1, MSL2 are working, clear section with 920 bar 500 amps because we cannot ensure working of MPH. After cleaning of section, normalize 1x1 switch. If HSL1 normal, DJ drips, defective QSL1. Similarly, if HSL2 normal, DJ drips, defective QSL2. You concentrate switch in 3 position. were duly observing MS1, MS2. After HVSL1, HVSL2, normal question, vision not read. HPH normal. Digit reps, effective MPH or QPH. So, contact TLC can work with 920 bar 500 amps as per the instructions of TLC. After HPH normal also, DG not rip. Defective PCR interval. So, already we have kept HPCR on 0, we can work normal during observing or known. Axillaries. With this, operation B part 1 completed.
Next, operation B part 2.
Abnormal sign. Rose PLD is a press PLD is a LS is extinguished, humidity evades, axillary sound had, LSHA also extinguished. On releasing PLD is a LS is a reclose. Effective Q30. So through Q30, effective Q30 or OHG is a bus tripping. While closing of DC, Q44 will get off through Q45. After closing of DC through Q30, the path will be maintained to Q44. When we release the PLRDC, this Q45 interlock will go back. So, path has to maintain through Q30. If Q30 is defective, after releasing of PLRDC, immediately disabled.
That is operation B part 2.
Defective Q30. So, troubleshooting. So, we have to wait Q45. In energized condition. So this Q45 should not wait when loco is having operation A&E trouble, that is Q severe defective. So Q45 wait, we have to follow some precautions. We will see the precautions to be followed if Q45 which ensure OHE, it should be above 17.5. If OHE getting less, no OHE, immediately trip the DC. Ensure working of MSA1, MSA2. If MSA1 not working or MSA2 not working, normal question through this QSA1, QSA2 DG will trip. If Q45 which DG will not hit, so ensure working of MSA1, MSA2. So DG will close. If BL is on, DG will close. So already Q45 which, so if BL is on, Q45 which, there is no necessity to operate BL or DG. So ensure at notice sections from DC open port to DC closed port, BL is in open condition. If DC trip, since Q45 was which, so DC will try to reclose. So whenever DC trip, open BLDC. In DG tripped condition, there is a chance for Q98 and Q44 charting. On Q98 branch, Q44 interlock is there. On Q44 branch, Q98 interlock is there. So when DG tripped condition, whenever Q8 will energize, Q8 normal open interlock will close and Q44 will energize. If Q44 will energize, So Q44 interlock will open and Q98 will de-energize. When Q98 de-energize, again Q44 will de-energize. So charting will take place. We have to wedge Q45, remove the wedge Q45 before closing of AC to get the other path to the Q9 through this release. If Q30 defective, so operation B part, we should not use RP. If you use RP, CTPs will throw to the traction side. So IP valve will de-energize, BP will drop. So RP should not be used. Q30 defective. If you wedge Q45, fuel also will bypass. So these precautions to be followed. If Q45 wedge.
Operation B part 2.
So finally, if Q45 wedge, we have to observe OHG. MSA1, MSA2 working. And if DJ trips are run, open BLDC to have a DJ chartering. DJ tripped condition, Q98 Q44 will charter. So remove the wedge before closing of DC only, Q45 wedge. At node sections, ensure BLDC in open condition. If BLDC is open, BLDC is closed, DC will close. So RP should not use. So KLB will bypass. So one precaution you have to follow. If any problem is there, we should not wait. If you thought of a wait. So thank you. With this operation B part was completed.
Next, operation O,
abnormal sign. After closing of DC means BLDC on, BLDC present hold, LSC extinguish, humidity debates, darkness on, hard, LSC also extinguish, we release the BLDC. Entire this process will call as after closing of DC. Wait for 15 seconds. After closing of BLMT, while counting 30 seconds, DJ trips, LS is here, reclose means
operation O.
Reasons: defective MERH or QRH, MEMT1, QMT1, MEMT2, QMT2. Initially, Q9 will have path through this. Through C9, C105, 106, 107, Q44 and Q46 will work. After closing of DC, through direct release and QCR, it will maintain. After closing of BLMT, this contact is C105, 106, 107 open. Q9 will get path through relay interlocks of MEMT1, MEMT2, MERH after starting of motors. These air circulation relays will energize and their contacts will interlocks will close and path will be maintained through this air circulation relays interlocks QMT1, QMT2, QRH. So one by one motors will start. First MERH will start. 8 seconds MEMT1, after 8 seconds MEMT2. So after closing of BLMT, while counting 30 seconds, if DJ trip means defect in MVRH or QVRH, MEMT1, QMT1, MEMT2, Q. So ensure working of these three motors. If any abnormality, isolate concern motors. If MARH is not working, 920 bar permanent. If MMD1 MLT is any smoke smell abnormality, concern truck isolate with the other truck 50% of margin. There is no abnormality in these motors. To find out the defective, we have to close the DC. For closing of DC, we have to keep switch positions HVMT1 on 3, HVMT2 on 3, HVRH on 3, and now we can close the DC. So DC will be maintained, the path will get through switches to Q1OH. Now we are able to close the DC. After keeping the switch positions on 3, after closing of DC, ensure working of MERH, MMD1, MMD2 after closing of PLMT. If MERH is not working, isolate MERH, clear section with the 920 bar 500 amps, starting 5 minutes 920, continuous 500 amps, inform TLC. If any MMT1 or MMT2 is not working, isolate concern truck by keeping switches HVS7, HVMT1, HVSL1 on 0 for truck 1. HVSA2, HVSL2, HVMT2 on 0 for truck number 2. Work with single truck, 50% of maximum load permitted. If all these three motors, MERH, MMT1, MMT2 working, defect in the relays. So defective QMD1 or QMD2 or QRH. Clear section, normalize 1x1 switch. First, keep HMD1 on one position. After keeping HMD1 on one position, if DJ trips, defective QMD1. 1x1 switch normalize. So if DJ not trip, keep HVMT2 on normal position, one position. If DJ trip, defective QMT2. After keeping HVMT1, HVMT2 normal position also, DJ not trip, defective QRH. So if any relay found defective QMT1, QMT2 or QRH, keep concern switch on 3 position, other switch is normal, duly observing that motor working, work further. This is the troubleshooting for operation O. First, ensure working of motors. If any abnormality, isolate concern motor and with precautions we have to work. So if there is no abnormality, switches HVRH, HVMT1, HVMT2 on 3 and close it easy. Put on VLMT, ensure working off. If any motor is not working, so concern motor isolate with precautions, you can work. MERH is not working, 920 bar 500 amps. MMT1 MMT is not working, after 50% of load. If all motors are working normal, create the section, normalize 1x1 switch. By normalizing 1x1 switch, if DJ trips, concern relay is defective, so isolate that relay, mains, concern switch in 3 position, duly working, duly observing working of motor and work normal. With this, operation O was completed. Next we will see operation 1. Operation 1. Abnormal sign. After closing of DC, wait for 15 seconds,
close wheel empty, wait for 30 seconds, take one notch. If DJ trips, there is an operation 1. Defective MESA1, QSA1, MESA2, QSA2, suggest operation of SMGR. After releasing BLRDC, so Q44 will get two paths, one through Q30 GR0, another through Q30 QSA1 QSA2. After taking first notch, this GR0 interlock will open, the path to be maintained through Q30 QSA1 QSA2 Q44. After taking off first notch, if DJ trip means defective MSA1, defective QSA1, defective MSA2, defective QSA2, or suggest operation of GR. GR taking excess time for its rotation. So for troubleshooting, ensure any abnormality in the MSA1, MSA2. If there is no abnormality, to find out the defective, keep the switches HVSA1 and HVSA2 on 3 position. Maintain a path to the Q44. The path will be maintained to Q44 through switches HVSA1, HVSA2 on 3 position. After closing of DC, ensure working of MESA1 and MESA2. If MESA1 is not working, isolate concerned truck by keeping HVSA1, HVMD1, HVSA1 on 0, work with 50% of maximum. If MSA2 is not working, isolate truck number 2 by HVSA2, HVSA2, HVMD2 on 0, work with single truck, 50% of maximum. If both motors are working, MSA1, MSA2, means defective either QSA1 or QSA2 or suggest operation of GR. So to find out the defective, take one notch. While taking one notch, already HVSA1 on 3 and HVSA2 on 3. If DJ trips, that is GR, ASM GR is defective. It's taking excess time for traveling. So try to clear section with manual operation. So after clearing of manual operation, so inform TLC as per the TLC instructions. We can improve SMGR pressure from 2.5 to 3.25 to max in the range of 2.5 to 3.5. And once find out the pressure, then you can try for SMGR malfunctioning. after taking off notch also, if DJ is not ripped, defective QSA 1, defective QSA 2. So clear section. After clearing off section, keep one by one switch normal. After keeping HV7 on normal position, if DJ drip, defective QSA1, if DJ not drip, defective QSA2. So concern switch we have to keep in 3, duly ensuring working of concern motor MESI can work normal in case of any of the relay QSA1, QSA2 is effective. One more important point. If any earth fault in V1 coil, while taking notch from GR0 to 1, the MP flow is on plus, V1 coil will access and one notch will focus. If any earth fault in V1 coil, so CCPD will melt. If CCPD melting, so panda also will lower, so negative panda lower, GR will not come to 0. So while taking first notch, if DJ trip, ensure panto is raised and touching to OHE for attending troubleshooting for
operation 1.
So for operation 1, first we would have to ensure CCPD in good condition, panto is in raised condition. Ensure working off, ensure any abnormality in MESA1, MESA2. If there is no abnormality, keep switches HVSA1, HVSA2 on 3. Close that easy and ensure working off MESA1, MESA2. If MESA1, MESA2 is working, okay. If not working, so I said consult truck, work with you 50% off load. If both motors are working, take one notch. DJ trip, that is reduced operation of GR. So clear section with mild operation. After taking first notch also, if DJ not ripping, defective QSA1, QSA2, after clearing off section, normalize one by one switch, find out the defective relay, and concern switch in 3 position, work normal, duly observing motor working. With this, operation 1 was completed. Next, we will see
operation 2.
Operation 2 of Dhamma sign. After closing of DZ, that means up to BLRD release. After closing of DZ, wait for 15 seconds. Close BLMT, wait for 30 seconds, take up your 6th notch. While counting 15 seconds, if LS is a reglow, if DJ trip, there is
operation 2.
Reasons for
operation 2.
Either all contactors C105, 106, 107, 102C. Or any one of the conductors C105, 106, 107, 102G
or their interlocks. Normally, open interlocks on covenant branch parallel to JR 025 interlock defective. After closing of bail MT, the third pass to the covenant. Supply will come like this. So, JR 025 and a dual path of normal open interlock C105, 106, 107 close parallel to the JR 025 on covenant branch. After taking 6th notch, this JR 025 interlock will open. So, the path has to maintain through like this 4th path only. So, if any problem in this path, that is all contactors C105, 106, 107 are not loose, any one of the contactor not loose, are their interlocks C105, 106, 107 interlocks effective, we will experience operation 2. All EM contactors, that means C105, 106, 107 are not closing. Now we are seeing Blue's control circuit. All 3 EM contacts are not closing. The defective may be with CCA fuse, Q100 interlock or BLMT switch. So you can see in the Blue's control circuit, all Blue contactors C105, 106, 107 and experiencing operation 2, defective may be CCA, Q100, BLMT, Q100 interlock. So we have to put on BLCPT. If compressor working, CCA is good, Q100 good, because compressor circuit also controlled by CCA fuse and Q100. If compressor also not working, defective either CCA or Q100. If compressor is working, take one notch and try. If blowers are working, defective BLMT. So after taking off first notch through MPC and GR1232, path was getting to the blowers, that is defective BLMT. After taking off notch also, if blowers are not starting, clean the interlocks of Q100. If still not success, all blowers are not working, so we can wait only maximum two EM contactors. So for loaded train, which C105, 106, both tracks has to work. And this current rating 920/100. Work as per the instructions of TLC. MT stock. So one truck, either C105 or 106 which. So other truck isolation and C107 which. Work with precautions. We're keeping concern switches on 3. Work with single truck without restriction of current ratings. Is the troubleshooting for all EM contacts are not working. If CCA fuse melting, replace the fuse, a good one. If again melting, over often replace.
Even Hova off also, if sees a melting, work with minimum contact switching. Here compressors and noise will not work. CCM melting even Hova off also. So compressor also will not work. Race also will not work. For working a train, we need minimum two compressors to be working. So maximum we can reach 2 EM conductors. Reach any 2 of the CP conductors. Continuous pressure will build up. Ensure working of SH2. Create a slight leakage in CDC before MR1 to maintain pressure between 8 to 9.5. Clear section within 5 notches because C1 or 7 not loose, only 5 notches will come. If load not permit, wait 2 minutes. Clear section as far as possible lower notches because lowest MEM-D1 M2 also not working. So as far as possible clear section with lower notches without exceeding current readings 920 bar 500. If CC melting even over off also. If 200 not energizing, so we can wait 200. If you wait 200 in energized position, you can work normal in some of the locus. Whenever DJ trip, the path will be maintained through self interlock of C107. So C107 contact will not open. So while closing of DC, we will experience ICDC. So remove the wedge and assess the loco, then wedge 200. If any one of the EM conductor not losing, for example C1 or 7 not, change the position of HVRH 1, 2, 3 and try. Check flexibility of the conductor C1 or 7. Any pit marks, weld marks clean. If not success, wedge C107 with a suitable wedge. Keep concern switch HVRH on 3 to maintain the path to the DC through Q9H. So ensure all 3 trips, conductor trips in closer position but normal. Similarly for C105. Change position of HMD1, 1, 2, 3 and try. Flexibility you can check, pit mass, weld mass, when it's clean. And we have to check for QTD1, 105 also. QTD 105 has to analyze. Similarly, C106, if C106 is not closing, keep HMD2 on 3 and try. Check the flexibility, any pit mass, weld mass. Check work whether QD106 was energized or not. So if not success, can wedge any one of the EM conductors, C105, 106, 107. If they are not closed, maximum we can wedge 2 EM conductors. This entire troubleshooting you have seen in conductors topic, EM conductors topic. all M conductors are closing. C105, 106, 107 closing. But experiencing the
operation 2
means normally open interlock of C105, 106, 107 are 200 branch defective. They are not closing. So we can try by keeping HMD1 on 3 and try. Not success. HMD2 on 3 and try. If not success, C107 normally open interlock is defective. So which 208 work with precautions. So operation 2. All M conducts not closing, or any one of the conducts not closing, or interlocks defective. All not closing. So close BLC bit and ensure CCR 200 good condition. If their CPs are working, CCA and 200 good condition. If CCA melting, even hob off also. Work with minimum contact switching. 200 is defective, we can wedge 200. If CCA on 200 is good, that means CPs are working, defective VLMT or 200 network. So take notch by. MP, if after getting a notch, if Lewis are starting, defective VLMT switch. If not success, we can clean interlocks of 200. If still not success, or loaded drain, we can wedge C105, 106. With current ratings, 120 bar panel we can mark. Light load, either one of the C105 or 106 which, the C10s on which, with normal working, with 50% upload we can mark. If 200 which, ICDJ experience of tripping of DC, remove the wedge, close DC, then wedge 200. 200 wedge, we have to give a time gap for closing of BLMT, BLCP for 5 seconds. If any one of the conductors C107 or C105 or 106 not closing, ensure concern switch in one position. Change to 3 and try. It's a flexibility. Any wet mass we have to check. QTD 105, 106 analyzation for C105, 106. For C107 with ACMRF locus, ensure CTF2 interlock on C107 coil. Gentry tap. If any one of the contact is not close, we can wedge, ensure concern switch on 3 position for getting path to the Q9H, and ensure 3 tips are closed properly. Work with precautions, duly observing what are working, we can work normal. If contact is closing, C105, 106, 107 closing, but we are experiencing operation 2 means their interlocks, normally open interlocks on unit branch parallel to JR05 is defective. Try by keeping HMD1, HMD2,
one by one on three questions and try. If not success, C1 not some interlock is defective. Normal interlock. Which cure on it? With precautions, we can work normal. With this, operation 2 was completed. Next, we will see digit ripping without apparent cause. Digit ripping without apparent cause. Number sign. Digit rips in various occasions other than proper reason. Reasons. Slackness of CCPD, CCDJ, CCE. Subject operation of SMGR at various notches. Panto bouncing or any momentary interlock defective on DJ condition. So with this reason we may experience DJ tripping without a front loss. For troubleshooting, check previous CCPD, CCDJ, CCA. If any slackness, we have to find. Change the panto and try. Improve the pressure 2.5 to 3.5 and try. So we can change the cap and try. With the mile operation also we can try. Gently tap the safety relays. If any of the relay targets, attempt troubleshooting. By HQA 0 and try, HQP 1 off and try, H2B2 off and try one by one. By keeping HOBO off also we can try. By wedging Q no night in NZ's condition we can try. Similarly by wedge 244 in NZ's condition also we can try. Like this one by one tries we have to do. If not success, contact TLC. If CCA melts on run, low ace and the compressors will not work. If we are on notches 6 and above, DC will because GR 0 to 5 interlock was open and C102 106 interlocks also open on the right match. DG will trip through this one. If CCA slack, well on one. So, Muller contacts will open. So, if you are in notches, C105, 106, 107 will open. So, DG will trip. If you are in coasting, DC will not trip to C105, 106, 107. At this time, if MR pressure drops, CPs also will not work if CC slack. If MR pressure drop, Cupid DC, DC will trip. So next problem, operation A and E part 2. This problem will come only in 5 branches VCB. Only 5 branches VCB also this problem will come. abnormal sign.
Close BLDC, press BLDC, LSH is extinguished, you will debate, as this sound had, LSH will also be extinguished. While releasing BLDC,
LSH is a repeat. Defective, DC interlock, DC normally open interlock on MDJ branch defective. So this interlock is defective. Initially this path is maintaining through Severite coil for closing of DC, but this due to this DC interlock defective. So while releasing BLDC, DC was tripping. So if this problem is experienced, contact TLC for advice. So with this all troubleshooting for different problems, ICDJ, noting shell, A beginning, A ending, B part 1, part 2, operation O, 1, 2, DJ tripping without apparent cause, and operation ending part 2 in 5 branches of O, completed. Thank you.